And this is going to make no sense, once again, for people who are watching it live. But hello, everyone. Hootoot, everyone. It's me, Ethan, out there, Turwile. And I'm back with some more Signalis. Because I don't know what else to spend my time on. So we're going to go back and try some more Signalis. Because honestly, we didn't get very far in Signalis when we did that initial stream on it. So now we're gonna get back to it and see what's what. We're going to see what's what. I don't really have much of... I honestly don't really remember what we were doing. We didn't get very far. We only spent like an hour in it, right? Like, hang on. So we have, okay, repair patch, which is health. We have a pistol. We have pistol ammo, and we have a photograph. I don't remember how to interact with anything. Okay, we picked up a repair patch. Does that take up two slots, or is... Nope, they stack. Excellent. Classic Resident Evil style storage there. I am seeing why people were describing this as being a, I feel like we've gotten into this. We've gone into this very perfunctorily. Like, I feel like I should have done a bit more of a song and dance about us starting this. But we're playing Signalis. Pick up East Wing Key. I picked up the East Wing Key. Excellent. Okay. What is this? More pistol ammunition. Thank you. Good. Ethy like gun. Pick up disposable stun rod? Electro impulse devices. Due to recent events, all facility staff members are encouraged to familiarize themselves with the use of electro-impulse devices. We've been supplied with a shipment of EIG-2 disposable stone prods for training purposes. Please refer to the enclosed handbook for more information. The electros... Fuck me. Electros... Electro-impulse Garrett! Electro-impulse Garrett EIG-2! The EIG-2 stun prod is a single-use, short-range, disposable, non-lethal solution for incapacitating non-cooperative individuals. It can be equipped to the tool slot in the inventory screen. Once equipped, it'll be shown on the lower left of the inventory screen. It can be used with one hand while on the move, and even while aiming another weapon. Once equipped, use the stun prod, press C when facing a nearby enemy. High voltage electrical discharge may arc to individuals close to the target. Use with care. Do not deploy an elderly, pregnant, or individuals with known heart disease. Unless absolutely necessary, dispose of stun prod properly after use. Excellent. Good. Memorandum wall safe codes. It's coming to my attention. At least one worker might be aware of the code broadcasting frequencies for the protector wall safe. So I'm pretty sure we read this the last time we played this. Yeah, pretty sure we did. Fuck. I have forgotten, like, everything. I have forgotten everything. Oh, excellent. You can actually do the classic, drag that in your inventory. Okay. I feel like we might have known the code for this before, and I've just forgotten. I'm very concerned. Nope. Okay, that's okay. I knew that for a di- okay. So I knew the thing of a different. How do I leave? Game. I don't want to be here anymore. Okay. Thank you, game. Thank you for freeing me from the safe. I was frightened there. I thought I might never get to leave the safe. That's just the handbook again. I thought I might be trapped in the safe forever. Wunderwaffen Unserenation im Kampf gegen das Reich Falken Einheiten. Fucking, okay. There's basically, whenever anything German comes up, that's gonna happen. I need you to be aware that in this game where there's a lot of German text, I am going to shout anything that I can read in very bad German. So, be aware of that. Subject, okay, interrogation. Subject worker S23A6514, Wilhelm Chen. Interesting combination of first and last name. Wilhelm Chen. Then again, actually, that checks out. Okay, hang on, I need to... Sorry, the artist responded. This is great watching. This is great watching. You know what? You know why I think I can get away with just, like, literally being on my phone while I'm streaming? It's the fact that I don't make any money. I feel like even if I made the amount of money that Edit Edward makes, which I don't know how much he makes, but I've seen people, like, drop shitloads of fucking free subs and shit, I'd feel bad about this. I don't make shit. Like, I don't give a fuck. I don't need to be acting. I don't even need to pretend to be professional. I could... Nah, fuck him. Okay. I don't know why I'm saying fuck, I'm talking to you, the audience in general, but you know what I mean. Okay, cool. I'm just confirming the price of something because the way they'd written their commissions were slightly ambiguous. It was unclear as to if the thing that they were offering was... It was unclear as to if it gets more complicated, if the commission would get more expensive if it was more complicated. Okay. Offense, contraband found in locker, result confession, punishment, no food for 3 cycles. No food for 3 cycles. So starving someone for 3 days. Well, okay. I've got to assume cycles means days, right? Like, that's... Like, we got to assume that's what it means in this context, because there's no way... Okay. Subject worker S23A3054, Michaela Wong, illegal use of radio, result confession, punishment isolation for 2 cycles. Subject Wolfgang Wong, illegal use of radio, expired during interrogation! Punishment none. Death, I'd say, would probably be the punishment there. Subject worker S23A, yeah, whatever. Franz Huo, obscenity to the state, passed out during interrogation, double work shift for 2 cycles. Yeah, obscenity to the state, that checks out. This is, you know, we are in space, we are in a space like communist hellhole, so that kind of checks out. Emily Huang, trespassing, fucking, okay, 2 of the 5 people they interrogated died. What the fuck is going on here? Is that even unusual, or is that just, like, how things be in, like, space East Germany? Like, is that just, like, par for the course up in here? Locked to the other side, okay. I mean, I guess we should go use this... Can I go down here? I don't remember anything about where we are, fuck. We should go see if we can use the... Oh, will this? Okay, there we go. Is that... Okay, that's actually used up the key. Okay. So we came up from there. Okay, I understand. I understand. But yeah, it is kind of strange to me that it seems like everything is a bizarre combination of Chinese and... German. Like, that's a... It's a combination of, like... A very specifically, like... Yeah, very specifically, like, East Germany, like, communist German and China. I mean, normally when something's being communist, it's not fucking German, is it? But normally when I see something being communist, it's, it's Russian, you know? Russian, maybe China. But, like, Germany? This is, like, a very bizarrely specific reference to, like, Cold War era Germany rather than anything, like, specific. Rather than, like... I don't know, it's not where my brain would go. I mean, that's not good. Okay, that's... It's breathing. Yep, that's a horrible pile of pulsating meat if I ever saw one. It's not great. That's not what I wanted. We got good use out of that disposable stun prod, though, eh? Just wrecked someone with it. Actually, you know, before we go any further, let's actually go back and dump some stuff in storage, because I am realizing that we are running around with an almost full inventory, and we can't, like, keep hoping that, like, we're just... You know what I mean? I love her Resident Evil Dino Crisis pose. Yeah, very... It is very specifically Resident Evil, isn't it? Like... Also, can we talk about how smooth the animation on them stubby feetsies is? On the spinning, look at that! Look at that, look at that! Buttery smooth, that animation! Buttery smooth going on down there! Okay. Okay. Put you in there. Put the repair spray in there. And that's it, as long as we've got, like, because then we've still got, like, yeah, we've got, like, two slots, so that's fine. I mean, we're probably going to run out of stun prods, like, almost immediately, so. So I'm going to just use it, because that seems to knock whatever I'm fighting down immediately, so. I'm probably going to waste the hell out of that, like, almost immediately. Can I, like, examine what's going on here? Whatever it is, it doesn't seem edible. You're a robot. Do you eat? Do you eat? What exactly is the nature of our character right now? Because I thought she was a human-looking robot. But actually, the name Replica... implies maybe something else? Okay, that appears to be the make of our character. Yeah, simple universal light replica, Yule. That looks like what we are, right? I think that's who we are. We're one of them. And actually, yeah, because that's also, like... I'm pretty sure that is, like, specifically... Yeah, that's, like, specifically our face as well. So, I assume we are a mass-produced robot. Mensa key. Cool. I don't know why we've got a key to Mensa, as far as I was aware. Be an android, like a replicant at a Blade Runner. I always forget, do they need to eat the replicants in Blade? It's been a long time since I've watched Blade Runner. Like, do they eat the replicants? Or more specifically, do they have to? Or is it like a thing that they can do, but they don't have to? Service request form R90. Full protector ID, unit, fuck it, whatever. Okay, so it was a replica. Status, staff, department, kitchen, work quarters, object, navigation module. My mapping module is still defective, much only map data. I keep getting lost on my way to work and back. I had to sleep in a hallway last cycle because I couldn't find the staff elevator to get to my dorm. Please, I can't find my way around this place without a map. Yikes. I know, my bad. They eat, drink, and relieve themselves just like humans. Okay, so this is one of the things that's always confused me about the replicants. And it's something that's always kind of bugged me. About the replicants in Blade Runner is I don't quite understand what the point of them is. Because they are close enough to normal humans to where I don't get... to where I don't, like, fully understand why they... why they're made. Like, I don't understand them as a product. You know? I don't get it. Like, because they're so close to human. Like, it just seems like they are unnecessary. Like, a completely unnecessary thing. Like, I would almost accept it as, like, some of them would exist. Because here's the thing, right? I can fully see humanity, like, real-world humanity, creating something like a replicant essentially as a science experiment. Like, to see if we can. But, like, I don't see the function of them if they can think they're human and if they are essentially... Because I know they're stronger than humans. I know that. Like, depending on what the replicant's been built for, they can just be better than humans in a lot of ways. But, like, a lot of them are just indistinguishable, and I don't understand the point of them being indistinguishable. Very, very sadly, I feel like someone made them to have fun having legal slaves. Okay, then. That would explain why one fucked up person would have them. It doesn't explain why a society would adopt them. You know? Also, the noises these things make are horrible. Oh, wait, what? Nope. Not going in there. Seem to be running into quite a few horribles at this stage. A broken key. Excellent. Good. It's just what I always wanted. A broken key. I also am not a big fan of the fact that even when on the ground, these things, like, the other, like, replicants or replicas or whatever the fuck keep, like, jittering horribly. Oh my god, are you alive? You look clean. You look like a normal starch. You don't look like you belong here. You're an Elster unit, right? This facility is currently on lockdown. You shouldn't be here. Is that... I'm the protector controller on duty on this level. I don't know what kind of business you have here, but as you can probably see, we've got bigger issues right now. If you're looking for the commander, I have bad news for you. She got sick and everyone else is getting sick too. That's really all I know about it. I'm sure the administrator knows more, but who knows where he is. I'm not going out there. I'm waiting here for new orders. Until then, I'm not taking any risks. Not going out there. Okay. The only thing was, as far as I know, a one-off that the main girl bot had a fun science experiment. The rest of them were cheap labor slash pleasure, but making them need to eat, drink is a bit far. You can just make a robot. Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, the replica, like... Just make, like, it's gotta be cheaper and easier to make them out of, like, metal. That's just like, boop, 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 boop. And, like, you just put, like, solar panels on their backs. Or have them plug into the wall. Rather than making the like, industrial replicants be, like, dudes who have to eat food and take a shit. Like, I don't understand. Because at that point, just use the poor like we use now. What the fuck? West Wing Key. Thank you. You don't mind if I take this? I mean, it looked like it had your face on it. Disposable stun prod. Thank you. You're just fine with me looting your stuff. Okay. About the administrator. From work shift controller to night shift controller. Due to recent events, some security technicians will be serving both work shifts and night shifts. Affected guard units. Those. Until an effective treatment is found or reinforcements sent from HIMAT, we'll all have to stay strong to do our best to keep the facility secure. Failure is not an option. Storch Cybern. Oh, wait, they have... Wait, so the... Hang on, the robots have last names. Although it looks like Storch is... The name Storch is just coming from STCR. Where's the Cybern coming from? Keep an eye on the administration unit since the incident he's been acting stranger than usual. Oh, fuck, the administrator's a dude. The administrator's a male robot. Without the commander, keep him in check. We'll have to ask... Colibri for help. Colibri? What? Gonna have to ask someone for help. Still just jerking around on the ground there. Nope. Now here's an interesting question. Can they follow me? that's one up for huge man. We at least have a man. Yeah, I mean, that's more. Might not be huge. I mean, it might be huge. We don't know. But it's more of a man than I thought we were going to have, so. How are we doing on ammo? Not great. Okay, I think we might need to. I have to do a Silent Hill on this one. Any advantage to the reprint? To the reprint? Replicants, I assume you meant. Is that they have a human. They have human mind that can use creativity and problem solving. Yeah, but the thing is that, like, most of the situations we find that they're used for, they don't need that. And also, yeah, like, why... So that is a very good point. Sure, the creativity is useful, but why does that require them to take a dump? Like... Is it impossible for a creature to be creative if it plugs into a wall? You know? Shit. That one got me. Oh wait, toilet thoughts. Shut up. Yes, we'd... Because occasionally normal human beings have been discovered to have revelations while they're taking a shit, we decided we needed to make our robots capable of taking a shit. Because that's when humanity is at its peak creativity. So we assume it's going to be the same for the robots. You know? Get on the ground! Okay. Stop resisting! Okay. More ammo. Oh, thank God. Okay. Do I have... I don't have, like, a knife or anything, do I? No. I am also noticing that they, like... There's a glitch effect on the enemies. Which... Like, that's odd. Like, is that supposed to be, like, our character's perception of them is, like, warped for some reason? Like, there's something about them which makes them hard for, like, another replica to perceive properly? I can't quite read. The Shaka-Sankansaka Protocol! I'm still on board for the inebriati from Mitch and Webb. Everyone does their best thinking after 1.5 glasses of wine. Robbers need to get pissed. I wouldn't know. I don't drink. Although I do often find that I have a lot of my most creative ideas when I'm kind of sleepy. Okay. Oh, wait, what's this? Search protocol. Worker, Helen Song, confiscated items, watch and ring, resident storm A16, workplace, political morals, class, arrested in ongoing investigation, stolen radio, original reason for transfer, counter-revolutionary activity, distributing flyers at university. Julia Huang, confiscated items and medication, resident storm A64, workplace mining operation A, arrested on suspicion of... Arrested on suspicion of bioresonance? What the fuck does that mean? Confiscated hydroxycarbamide pills have been sent to the medical wing. Special supervision request has been forwarded to Calibri. Alina Sio, cosmetic box of the butterfly inlay locked. Dom A61. Workplace factory collapsed at the workplace from exhaustion. Bunk was searched before transfer to medical wing. That's presumably what we got the key for. Heinrich Fukuyama. Fuck me. Heinrich Fukuyama. Also, Fukuyama. I don't think it's China. I think it's just Asia. Because Fukuyama is very Japanese. Sorry, can we quickly talk about how excellent the name Heinrich Fukuyama is? Like, that sounds like the trigger phrase if you want to really fuck off Captain America by reminding him of the Japanese and the Germans at the same time. Like, if you just want to, like, you just want to make a dude who, like, who fought in the, like, an American veteran of the Second World War go into the fucking Red Rage as you... German first name, Japanese last name. Jesus fucking wept. Mining Operation A rests on suspicion of conspiracy against the state. Okay. I think that motherfucker had a stun prod. Okay. A health patch on me there. Okay, this room blows. Also, I'm now out of ammo. Shit, I'm now out of ammo. Fuck, okay. Oh, wow, and this room, like, mad wasn't worth it. I just saw some on the floor and thought it mattered, but it was just, like, a health pickup. Hey, do you remember when I said that last room sucked? I didn't know this was what was about to happen. Just so we're absolutely clear. I didn't know that, like, that room was gonna look, like, really jolly in comparison to what the fuck is going on in the next room. Frequencies. Moon, sun, scales, rook, tree, sword. Okay. I mean, that's for a puzzle, isn't it? That's like very, I think pretty fucking explicitly for a puzzle, that one, isn't it? You don't come at me with like, rook, sun, like, you know, in a game like this, you know, and a game like this does not mention the word rook out of context unless it's for a goddamn puzzle, like, because that's some Silent Hill puzzle shit, being like, ah, yes, rook, the frequency of rook, it's like, fucking excellent, good, perfect, we love it. Can't go that way, gotta go this way. Yep, you're still dead and glitching out. Oh, that one got back up. That's locked. I think I just panicked when I came through here because there were enemies. Right? Is that why I... No, that's not why I panicked through here. I panicked through here because there was nowhere for me to go. I remember. Okay. It's not ideal. Okay, there's one more that I don't know. Oh, okay. I didn't know this was here, but okay. Use the butterfly key. Yes, yes, please. Thank you. Oh, yeah? A mysterious artifact. Pick up Plate of Eternity. Oh, yeah? The Plate of Eternity's turned it into a first-person game. Guys, I'm frightened. The game's first-person now. Oh, shit. REM, long wave radio receiver, module user manual. Module allows a replica unit to directly receive and process low frequency amplitude modulation radio. It's on the module slot behind the left ear. To access this module's function over the inventory stream, press W to subsystem. Pick up the radio module? Yes. Okay, so that. That means we can. Because we got those frequencies, so we can use those frequencies, I assume. To Radio Officer Young, Station 6. Dear Iris, I hope you and Arian? Nope, fuck it, it's not that one. Are both well. Well, I mean, it's German, it might be that one. I've spoken to the officials at Aeon, and they agreed that it would be for the best for Ariane to attend school in Sector C. I have a spare room she can stay in until she graduates. I know you two are inseparable, but we both know that this is best for your daughter if she receives a normal education in the city. Love, your sister, Camilla. Weird books. K4 ration. Radiator. Okay, I can't, like, interact with the computer. Okay, I think these might. Oh wow, you just leave it on while you're like walking around. Okay, I'll try that in the actual thing. What's this? Okay, so that. Okay, so that needs to be at 1600? No, it's 160, not 1600. What am I talking about? Cool. Okay, well, we now have that. Okay, let's try these frequencies here then. I don't know if it'll matter, but... I mean, we should try it in the... You know, let's go try them in the actual... In the room we found the frequencies thing. Because we found them in here, so it might matter more in here. Ah! It's the safes. It's the safes. I see. Tree is 188. A lot of spooky things in the radio here. Excellent. And there's gonna be a human head. Nope. Okay. Pick up an ID card. An identification card from a member of the Protector medical staff authorizes access to the Protector elevator. Okay, cool. It's fine, we're a god. Okay, so yes, this bit is a bit shorter, but this was a full-length stream cut into two parts. I will be back tomorrow with some more just Signalis. But that is going to be all from me for now. Hopefully you enjoyed both this and the Armin Observation Duty stuff that happened before, and hopefully I will see you guys next time. But before I leave, let's just quickly check to see if there's anyone we can raid. Survey says no. So, yeah, that's gonna be all for me for now. Hopefully I'll catch you next time. Bye!
The emancipation of the working class is the task of the worker alone. So left to three, so left to three, to the work that we must do. March on in the workers' united front, for you are a worker too.